on the historic date of 15th August 1947, India woke up to freedom from British domination. It was the culmination of numerous movements and struggles that were rife throughout the time of British rule, including the historic revolt of 1857. This independence was achieved through the efforts of many revolutionary freedom fighters who struggled for ensuring India's freedom. Decades later, we continue to celebrate this day when we became a free and sovereign nation, unaware of the value of freedom we enjoy today, owing to the indefatigable zeal and sacrifices of these freedom fighters.
आजादी का अमृत महोत्सव यानी आजादी की ऊर्जा का अमृत.
On the occasion of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, an initiative of the Government of India to celebrate 75 years of progressive India and the glorious history of its people, culture and achievements. We present to you Dakshin Bharat's legacy of sacrifice to spotlight the struggles of few prominent and other unsung heroes of the India's freedom struggle from the southern part of the country.
Alluri Sita Rama Raju was like a warrior for tribal people who opposed the British rules. Mainly, he revolted in the Rampa Rebellion in 1922 in present Andhra Pradesh. He made many attacks on the police station and killed several British officers, but at last he was caught up by British in the Chintapalli forest and was killed by tying on a tree and fired with a gun. Uyyalavada Narasimha Reddy is a freedom fighter from Andhra Pradesh who was known for his bravery and helping nature for the poor. In the first half of the 19th century, he and his team protested against the new rules introduced by the British, which exploited the low status cultivators. It is estimated that he has killed almost 3,000 British people. Gotipatti Brahmayya is well known for his active participation in the freedom movement, whether it is Simon's Commission or the Quit India movement. He involved in all major events and even went to jail protesting against the British. He was awarded the Padma Bhushan in 1982 for his contributions to the nation. Chaudhary Satyanarayana, also known as Jananayak Chaudhary Satyanarayana, was an Indian freedom fighter, anti-colonial nationalist, politician, legislator in Andhra Pradesh Assembly, and a civil rights activist. Drawing inspiration from Mahatma Gandhi, Subhash Chandra Bose, and great leaders, he took part in the freedom movement and participated in satyagrahas and protests against the colonial rule. Due to his involvement in the freedom movement, he underwent jail sentence. Kalluri Chandramouli, a devotee of Lord Rama who joined the freedom movement and got arrested multiple times for his actions against the British government. Vavilala Gopalakrishna, born in 1906 at Satanpalli in Guntur district of Andhra, started his career as a journalist and later got himself involved in the freedom struggle who is revered as the Andhra Gandhi. Kaniganti Hanumantu, a rebellion who was against paying of taxes to the British, was a peasant leader involved in the revolt and was killed by a British officer. His question was simple. We irrigated the crops in our land. Why we need to pay taxes? Chandra Pulla Reddy, born in Velugodu village, currently located in the Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh, was a leading activist in the Indian freedom struggle against British colonial rule as a student of Guindy Engineering College of the then Madras, who faced expulsion from the college due to his involvement in the freedom struggle. Sardar Gotu Lachanna, known for his bravery, who involved in Salt Satyagraha, Quit India Movement and more. He was arrested when he was just 21 years. He was given the title Sardar for his fearless fight against the British. Tanguturi Prakasam was a barrister who took very important cases. He was inspired by Bipin Chandrapal speeches and joined as editor of Swarajya newspaper. He actively participated in all major freedom movements and bringing the masses together to support the cause. Acharya N.G. Ranga joined his hands to Gandhi's call in 1930. He wrote many books to educate people related to public causes, and the famous one was Bapu Blesses, where he had written his discussions with Gandhiji. Kasi Naduni Nageshwara Rao, better known as Nageshwara Rao Pantulu, was an Indian journalist, nationalist, politician, businessman, and a staunch supporter of Khadi movement. He was conferred with the title Deshbandhu, Friend of the Masses, by the people of Andhra Pradesh. He was involved in the Salt Satyagraha of the 1930s, led by Gandhi, and spent 6 months in the prison for this. While in prison, Rao wrote an exposition on Bhagavad Gita, a sacred text of India. He argued in this that the Bhagavad Gita did not belong to a particular religion, but rather to the entire humanity as a scripture of yoga for spiritual enlightenment and prosperity of the entire world. Potti Sri Ramulu was an Indian freedom fighter and revolutionary. Sri Ramulu is revered as Amar Jeevi, immortal being in the Andhra region, for his self-sacrifice for the Andhra's cause. He took part in Indian independence movement and was imprisoned for participating in the 1930 Salt Satyagraha. Between 1941 and 1942, he participated in the individual Satyagraha and the Quit India movement and was imprisoned on 3 occasions. Mahatma Gandhi once said, "If only I have 11 more followers like Sri Ramulu, I will win freedom from British rule in a year." Swami Ramanand Tirtha was an Indian freedom fighter, educator, and a social activist who led the Hyderabad liberation struggle during the reign of Osman Ali Khan, the last Nizam of Hyderabad state. He participated in Satyagraha's non-violent resistance campaigns and was imprisoned for 111 days by Osman Ali Khan. Swami Ramanand Tirtha is credited for having created a revolutionary movement to integrate Hyderabad state with the Indian Union in 1948. Pingali Venkaya was a Gandhian ideologist. He met Mahatma Gandhi in South Africa during the Second Boer War, where he was posted there as part of the British Indian Army. There, an incident when the soldiers had to salute the Union Jack, the British national flag, stayed in his mind. After returning to India, he dedicated himself to the creation of the national flag for the country. In 1916, he even published a booklet on flags of other nations, a national flag for India, offering nearly 30 designs of what could make the Indian flag. Kittur Rani Chennamma was the first female activist for the independence of India who fought against the British Empire. Chennamma could not beat them, but she inspired many women to rise against British rule in the country. She was the queen of the princely state Kittur in Karnataka. Sangoli Rayanna was leading the army of the Kingdom of Kittur, which was ruled by Rani Chennamma, and fought against the British East India Company in 1824. He kept on fighting even after the Queen was imprisoned, but at last he was caught and was hanged in 1932. He is remembered for his braveness and loyalty towards his kingdom. Kundapur was the lady of Hubli district who organized large volunteers at the time of freedom struggle, encouraged local women who did not earlier step out of their homes. During her childhood, she moved to Mumbai with her family. Jallianwala Bagh incident changed her route of life and joined the freedom movement with great revolutionaries. Karnad Sadashiva Rao is a freedom fighter from the state of Karnataka. He was involved in the Indian independence movement, and with his wife Shantabai's support, he founded Mahila Sabha to help poor women and widows. He was a true follower of Mahatma Gandhi. Tipu Sultan, also known as the Mysore Tiger, ruled the Mysore Kingdom from 1782 to 1799. He was also a scholar, soldier, and a poet. He fought many battles with the British and took French support initially. Onake Obawa is a heroic woman who showed her braveness to the world and respect towards her husband when an army attacked the Chitradurga Empire. She alone fought till her husband noticed, and she died while in the process. Dr. N. S. Hardikar was closely associated with Lala Lajpat Rai and involved in the freedom struggle, not in the front face, but by lecturing and selling books promoting the sentiments. Yashodhara Dasappa took active part in the Indian independence struggle as well as several social movements such as Forest Satyagraha movement of the 1930s, which resulted in the imprisonment of over 1,200 people, and the Vidurashwata episode of 1938, where 35 people were killed in a police firing. For partaking in this movement, she was jailed. Her home was a meeting point for underground Satyagrahi independence struggle activity. She wrote and gave many aggressive speeches against the government when it decided to name a building after Hamilton, who was known for his brutality against the protesters agitating for freedom. V. N. Shenoy Oke, at a young age, joined India's freedom struggle and contributed to the freedom struggle with his art forms. He was jailed for picketing during his learning period at J.J. School of Arts, where he came in contact with Yusuf Meher Ali, who had interned him for the Quit India movement and was planning and scripting India's freedom struggle, with Oki decided to help. He was jailed for picketing during his learning period at J.J. School of Arts, where he came in contact with Yusuf Meher Ali, who had interned for the Quit India movement and was planning and scripting India's freedom struggle, which Oki decided to help. Kamala Devi Chattopadhyay, freedom fighter and more, was born in Mangaluru, and her remarkable life journey included significant contributions to the society. During the Salt March to Dandi, she convinced Gandhiji to give women equal opportunity to be in the forefront of the march. Later, she joined Seva Dal and trained women activists. However, the British government banned Seva Dal and threw into jail. There, she contracted jaundice. Having experienced the pathetic condition of the prison hospital, she built a hospital for inmates upon release. Ranganath Divakar was a Gandhian who became famous for his writing. He wrote several books on Gandhi, Satyagraha, and many others. Haider Ali was the ruler of Mysore Kingdom, father of the great revolutionary Tipu Sultan. He offered strong resistance against the military advances of the British East India Company during the First and Second Anglo-Mysore Wars and pioneered the military use of iron shell Mysurian rockets. He also greatly developed Mysore's economy. Muduvidu Krishna Rao is a great journalist who helped in uniting the people of Karnataka by creating awareness through thoughts and writings. His critic writings about the British government in his editorials created large impact through awareness generation among masses. K.G. Gokhale served his life by giving education to the poor, who conducted a Harijan school under a peepal tree. He also participated in the non-cooperation movement and went to jail. He was the first man in Karnataka to lead a group of volunteers to Ankola from Belgaum for performing salt satyagraha. R.S. Hukerikar was one among those who have put efforts to shape Karnataka. His patriotism made him arrest for 7 years in jail, but still he continued to protest against the no tax system in Karnataka and also worked to unite Karnataka on a linguistic basis. T. Subramaniam was one of the influencers of people who also edited a Kannada weekly called the Karnataka Kesari. He later resigned and participated in civil disobedient movement and went to jail and paid a fine of ₹200 in those days. Bellari Siddamma was a follower of Gandhi and spiritual mind, worked for public life throughout her entire life. Despite the efforts of our freedom fighters, they were hanged. At this time, Siddamma decided to throw the British out of the country. She unfurled the national flag and got arrested. After her release, she again started to unite and educate people. At the age of 18, Nittur Srinivasa Rao participated in the independence movement from 1930s and actively contributed for the civil disobedience movement. Born in a poor family, N.S. Rajpurohit was self-taught and qualified himself for teaching in primary schools. Due to his active participation in India's freedom in anti-British activities, he found himself dismissed and disqualified from teaching for rest of his life. He wrote many books, mainly on history, but none of his works were remembered today. Before the British colonization in India, there were many others who tried to dominate the country. One among the groups was the Portuguese. Abaka Chauta was the first woman freedom fighter who fought against them in the 16th century. The Portuguese made several attempts to capture Ullal as it was strategically located, but Abaka repelled each of their attacks for more than 4 decades. Gangadhar Rao Deshpande was a trusted lieutenant of Gandhi. He started his career as a lawyer and served many other roles. In the fight for the nation's freedom, he went 3 times for jail. He played an important role in politics and unified Karnataka. He worked closely with great leaders who worked for the nation. Nagamma Patil was the follower of Gandhi who brought the national movement to Karnataka and also worked her entire life for providing education to the Harijan children, particularly the girls. She participated in the freedom movement and got arrested in Belgaum for 3 months and also 13 months in the Yerwada Central in 1942. Palasi Raja was a prince of the kingdom of Kottayam in Malabar. In 1796, the king of Palasi left his kingdom due to the East India Company and took shelter in the Wayanad forests. Then he used tactics against the British. Even he had to fight with Tipu Sultan and Hyder Ali troops. A.V. Kuttimallu Amma was a great woman freedom fighter who was active in the freedom movement, who showed Keralite the right path to fight against the British. She actively participated in many national movements like the Swadeshi movement, civil disobedience movement. During the protests, she was arrested for leading a group, and sadly her 2 years old daughter had to stay in jail with her. K. Kumar was the earliest socio-political leader who spread Gandhi's message and brought spirit in the people of Travancore state to fight against the British by following Gandhian principles. He has close ties with well-known prominent leaders like Pandit Nehru, C.R. Das and leaders alike. The entire efforts of his life were to bring communal harmony. Akkamma Cheriyan was popularly known as Jhansi Rani of Travancore. The name didn't come just like that. She gave up her teaching profession and joined the freedom movement. The Travancore people started protesting for a responsible government where she led a group. Meanwhile, British police chief ordered men to fire, but she cried and told to shoot her first. Even British officer got sympathy and withdrew their order. For her courage, Gandhi hailed her as the Jhansi Rani of Travancore. Muhammad Abdur Rahman was a great Muslim freedom fighter from Kerala. He tried to establish peace in riot-afflicted areas and also participated in salt satyagraha, for which he was imprisoned for 9 months. He was the editor and publisher of the Malayalam daily newspaper Al Amin, in which he tried to nurture nationalism among the Muslim people of Malabar, but finally it was closed down by the British authorities. K. Kelappan, popularly known as Kerala's Gandhi, gave the lead to Payyanur and Calicut salt satyagraha and was chosen as the first satyagrahi from Kerala in the individual satyagraha movement launched by Gandhiji. He played a dominant role in the famous Vaikom satyagraha and was the leader of Guruvayur satyagraha in 1932. He went to jail several times during the freedom struggle, including the Quit India movement. He worked hard for eradication of untouchability and worked for uplift of Harijans and set up many Harijan hostels and schools in Kerala. He was in the forefront of Swadeshi movement and did his best to build up a base of khadi and village industries. Many do not know Kelappan as an editor of Matrubhumi in 1929 and 1936. Swadeshabhimani Ramakrishna Pillai used his writing skills as the weapon against the British by reaching masses in Travancore, Kerala, with his criticism in popular newspaper Swadeshabhimani and other papers. Vaikom Muhammad Bashir is a well-known writer known as Bepor Sultan. While at school, he fell under the spell of Gandhi, whom he saw at the Vaikom Satyagraha, and he resolved to join the fight for an independent India. Leaving school, he participated in salt satyagraha and was in prison. Even after he was released, he didn't keep quiet. He organized an anti-British movement and took an active part in freedom movement. Vaikom Maulavi was the founder and publisher of the newspaper Swadeshabhimani, which was banned by the British officers because of critics against the Travancore government. He stood as the voice of Muslim community and brought social reforms like modern education, women education, and worked towards the elimination of bad customs followed by Muslim communities. Vellayankode Umar Kasi is a Muslim scholar and freedom fighter who took active participation in the civil disobedience movement and fought against the British opposing to pay taxes. Vaikom Majid is a freedom fighter actively who led the national movement in Kerala. He was arrested after he participated in Quit India movement in 1942. K. P. Kesava Menon was the founder and editor of Matrubhumi in 1923. He was engaged in spreading the national movement messages through his newspaper. A. K. Gopalan worked for 7 years as a primary school teacher before leaving his job to launch himself fully into the fight for freedom. He focused not only on the freedom of British rule but also on the freedom of all forms of oppression, economic and social. He was behind bars when India became independent on August 15, 1947. He was released a few weeks later. P. Krishna Pillai was a great revolutionary from Kerala. He participated in Vaikom Satyagraha and Salt Satyagraha. In later years, he actively engaged himself to improve the social and economic conditions of the people of Kerala. Matai Manjuran, a revolutionary freedom fighter, socialist and prominent leader in the formation of Kerala state. As a fearless freedom fighter, his participation in 1942 Quit India movement and strategic plans with his friends near railway bridges at the Malabar regions showed his courage. Panampilly Govindamenon was a freedom fighter, politician and lawyer. He also worked with the national leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru during the freedom struggle. He undertook people-friendly reforms in the fields of education, industry, food distribution, etc. Velu Thambi Dalava, the minister of Balarama Varma Maharaja of Travancore, he has often been cited as a historic start in the first of the emancipation of the British. It has yet to be classified historically as part of the first phase of India's fight for independence. His word kept at the Napier Museum in Trivandrum is a salient reminder of this patriotic heroic fight against British rule. Subramanya Bharati, he is one of the well-known Tamil poets who wrote poems regarding patriotism, caste and religious views. He fought for caste system in Tamil Nadu. Tirupur Kumaran started Deshbandhu Youth Association by grouping the youth and young persons from Tamil Nadu to struggle against the British government to get freedom. He was holding the flag of Indian nationalists, which had been banned by the British, giving rise to the epithet Kodikatha Kumaran in Tamil, which means Kumaran who protected the flag. Veeramangai Velu Nachiyar was the first queen to fight against the British colonial power in India. She formed an army and sought an alliance with Hyder Ali with the aim of launching a campaign against the East India Company in 1780. When Velu Nachiyar found the place where the East India Company stored some of their ammunition, she arranged a suicide attack on the location, blowing it up. Vanchinathan Iyer, popularly known as Vanchinathan or Vanchi, was an Indian reactionary. He is best remembered for murdering Robert Ashe, the tax collector of Tirunelveli. Veera Pandya Kattabomman, he was an 18th century Tamil Palayakarar and chieftain in Tamil Nadu. He refused to accept the sovereignty of British East India Company and waged a war against them. V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, he was the first man in Tamil Nadu who started shipping trade between Tuticorin and Colombo. Valliyappan Ulaganathan Chidambaram Pillai, popularly known by his initials V.O.C., also known as Kappalottiya Tamilan or the Tamil Helmsman, was an Indian freedom fighter. Subramanya Siva was an Indian freedom fighter, writer, and pure Tamil movement activist during the independence movement. He was arrested by the British and was first political prisoner in Madras jail. While serving a prison term, he was afflicted by leprosy and was shifted to Salem jail. Marudu Pandiyar. The Marudu Pandiyars were king of Sivagangai, Tamil Nadu, India towards the end of the 18th century. They were known for fighting against the East India Company. They were finally executed by the East India Company after being captured by them. They are the first to proclamation of independence. They were good at aerodynamics and craftsmanship and is said to have invented the Valari, a variant of boomerang. They also founded guerrilla war tactic in India during the early stages of colonization. They gave protection to Velu Nachiyar, who was temporarily seeking refuge from the chaos of the war. They were hanged in the fort of Tiruputtur, which is now in Sivagangai district of Tamil Nadu. Lakshmi Sagal was a revolutionary of the Indian independence movement, an officer of the Indian National Army, and the Minister of Women's Affairs in the Azad Hind government. Lakshmi is commonly referred to in India as Captain Lakshmi, a reference to her rank when taken prisoner in Burma during the Second World War. She organized relief camps and medical aid in Calcutta for refugees who streamed into India from Bangladesh. Sir Subramanya Iyer was an Indian lawyer, jurist, and freedom fighter who, along with Annie Besant, founded the Home Rule Movement. He was popularly known as the Grand Old Man of South India. He went on to practice as lawyer in Madurai and Madras before being appointed as judge of the Madras High Court in 1891. He also served as the first Indian Chief Justice of the Madras High Court before retiring in 1907. Palayakara rebel Pulithevar. Pulithevar was a Tamil polygar who ruled Nerkattum Seval, situated in Sankaran Koil Taluk, Tirunelveli, Tamil Nadu. He is notable for leading a revolt against company rule at 1757 in India. He was the first Indian to fight against the British. He is known for the polygar's revolt against the British. Omathurai and Sevathaya. Omathurai, real name Kumaraswamy, was an Indian palaikarar from Tamil Nadu who fought against the British East India Company in the Polygar War. He was the younger brother of Veerapandiya Kattabomman. He died due to hanging by British in Thirumayam, Pudukottai district in Tamil Nadu. In February 1801, he escaped from Palayamkottai and rebuilt the Panchalan Kurichi fort, which has been raised in the first war. In the second Polygar War that followed, he allied himself with Marudu brothers who ruled Sivagangai and was part of Grand Alliance against the company, which included Dheeran Chinnamalai and Kerala Verma. Thillayadi Valliyammai. Thillayadi Valliyammai was a South African Tamil girl who worked with Mahatma Gandhi in her early years when she developed her non-violent methods in South Africa fighting its apartheid regime. Valliyamma and her mother Mangalam joined the second batch of Transvaal women who went to Natal in October 1913 to explain the inequity of the £3 tax of the workers and persuade them to strike. Valliyamma's father R. Munuswamy Mudaliyar, owner of a fruit and vegetable shop in Johannesburg and a satyagrahi in the Transvaal, was recovering from an operation. They visited different centers and addressed meetings. They were sentenced in December to 3 months with hard labor and sent to Maritzburg prison. Valliyamma fell ill soon after her conviction but refused an offer of early release by the prison authorities. She died shortly after release on 22nd February 1914. Seshadri Srinivasa Iyengar. Seshadri Srinivasa Iyengar, also known as Srinivasa Iyengar was an Indian lawyer, freedom fighter, and politician from the Indian National Congress. Iyengar was the Advocate General of Madras Presidency from 1916 to 1920. Srinivasa Iyengar was the youngest lawyer from the Madras Bar to be made Advocate General. Srinivasa Iyengar was also the mentor of freedom fighters. Kadalur Anjalai Ammal. Anjalai Ammal was a prominent freedom fighter in the Indian struggle for independence. She was the first woman from South India to take part in non-cooperation movement in 1921. She sold her family lands, her house, and spent the money for India's struggle for freedom. In 1927, she participated in the struggle for removing Neelan's statue. She also made her 9-year-old child, Amma Kannu, to participate in the struggle for removing Neelan's statue and went to jail along with her daughter. She raised her 9-year-old child in the prison. Gandhi visited Amma Kannu and Anjalai Ammal often in the prison. He renamed Amma Kannu as Leelavati and took her to Varada Ashram. She was badly wounded due to her participation in the Salt Satyagraha in 1930. She took part in another struggle for which she was sent to Vellore prison. She was pregnant while she was sent to Vellore prison. Once Gandhi came to Kadalur, but the British government prohibited him to visit Anjalai Ammal. But Anjalai Ammal came in a horse cart wearing a burqa and visited him. Due to her courage, Gandhi called her South India's Jhansi Rani. C. Rajagopalachari is popularly known as Rajaji or C.R., also known as Mudarinyar Rajaji. He became a true follower of Mahatma Gandhi. He actively participated in Vaikom movement in 1924 and 25 against untouchability. He was imprisoned in 1930 during the Dandi March. Sardar Vedaratnam Pillai was an Indian freedom fighter and a famous philanthropist who is known for his heroic contributions in the Salt March of Vedaranyam in 1930 along with C. Rajagopalachari. Namakkal V. Ramalingam Pillai. V. Ramalingam Pillai was a Tamil poet from Tamil Nadu, India, and independence fighter. He is well known for his poems about independence. The poem Kathi Indri Ratham Indri Yuttam Indri Varugudu Satyathin Nithyathai Nambum Yarukum Servir was a very famous poem among freedom fighters. Rukmini Lakshmi Pati. Rukmini Lakshmi Pati was an Indian independence activist who was the first woman to be elected to the Madras legislature and the first to serve as a minister in the Madras presidency. For her participation in 1930 in the Salt Satyagraha in Vedaranyam, she was jailed for a year, becoming the first female prisoners in the Salt Satyagraha movement. Dhiran Chinnamalai. He was a Palayakarar, Pattakarar who fought against the British East India Company. Chinnamalai engaged in guerrilla warfare and defeated the British in battles at Kaveri. Gazulu Lakshmi Narasu Chetty. Gazulu Lakshmi Narasu Chetty was an Indian merchant and Indian independence activist who founded the Madras Native Association, one of the earliest Indian political associations and the first Indian-owned newspaper in Madras, The Crescent. T. Sadasivam was inspired by the writings of many great leaders like Lala Lajpat Rai, Lokmanya Tilak, Bipin Chandrapal and Arbinda Ghosh and later joined freedom movement. He later started following Mahatma Gandhi's principles of non-violence and spreading awareness through his magazine named Kalki. Kamala Ramaswamy was one of the four women who had participated in the Quit India movement in Trichy. Dr. J. C. Kumarappa, a great Gandhian economist who was closely associated with Mahatma Ji, spent his last 4 years at the ashram. He came and settled down at the invitation of the founder, and it was he who registered the ashram as a society in the year 1956. During his time, several great men like Sri Rajendra Prasad, the first president of India, and Sri Acharya Vinoba Bhave visited the ashram.
Listening and understanding the immense sacrifices made by these great freedom fighters would definitely enthuse the youth of India to value the sacrifices of these great leaders whose legacy of sacrifice we are enjoying and contribute to the growth of our glorious nation.